아버지를 살해했는지 확인해 보기 위해 햄릿은 연극을 준비하고, 연극 후 진실을 알게 된 햄릿은 자신의 어머니인 걸트루드를 비판하고 심지어 살인을 저지르고 맙니다. 함께 지켜보시죠.
Take your gift back. Rich gift throws their prize. When the giver turns out not to be so nice. Tear my
rod. Are you good?
Excuse me?
Are you beautiful?
My rod, what are you talking about?
I'm just saying that if you're good and beautiful, your goodness should have nothing to do with your beauty.
But could beauty be related to anything better than goodness?
Sure, since beauty's power more easily changes a good girl into a whore, then the power of goodness changes a beautiful girl into a virgin. I used to love you.
You certainly made me believe you did my word.
You shouldn't have believed me. We are all rotten at the core. No matter how hard you try to be virtuous, I didn't love you.
Then I guess I was misled.
Get yourself to a convent at once. Why would you want to give birth to more sinners? I'm very good myself, but even so, I could accuse myself of such horrible crimes that it would have been better if my mother had never given birth to me. I'm arrogant, bashful, ambitious, with more ill will in me than I can fit into my thoughts. Why should people like me be crawling around between earth and heaven? Every one of us is a criminal. Don't believe any of us. Hurry up to a convent. Where's your father?
He is at home, my lord.
Lock him in so he can play the fool in his own home early. Goodbye.
Oh, dear God, please help him.
If you marry, I'll give you this curse as your wedding present. Be as pure as the driven snow, and you'll still get a bad reputation. Get yourself to a convent at once. Or if you must get married, marry a fool, since wise men know far too well that you'll cheat on them. Goodbye.
Dear God, please make him no more again.
I've heard all about you women and your makeup too. God gives you one face, but you paint another on top of it. You dance, and you prance, and you lisp. You call God's creations by pen names, and act all your sins when you're anything but that. Get out of it. I won't stand for it. It's driving me crazy. I now declare we will have no more marriage. Whoever is already married will leave home. All but one person. Everyone else will stay single. Get yourself to a convent fast.
Oh, how noble his mind used to be, and how lost he is now. He used to have a gentleman's grace, a scholar's wit, and a soldier's strength. He was the jewel of our country, the prince. Everyone admired and followed. And now he has fallen so low. Of all the miserable women who once enjoyed his sweet, charming words, I am the most miserable. A mind that used to sing so sweetly is now completely out of tune, making harsh sounds instead of fine notes. He has been ruined by madness. Oh, how miserable I am to see him now, knowing what he was before.
May the earth refuse me food, and the heavens go dark. May I have no rest day and night. May my trust and hope turn to despair. May the gloom of a prison overtake me. And may my every joy turn to sorrow. May I know no peace either in this life or the next one if I become a wife again after I am a widow.
Oh, nice vow, but what if she breaks it?
You have made this vow with deep sincerity, my dear. Leave me alone now a while. My mind is getting foggy, and I would like to sleep and escape this endless day.
Sleep. nothing come between us.
Madam, how are you liking this play?
Oh, the lady is overdoing it, I think.
Oh, but she'll keep her word.
Do you know the plot? Is there anything offensive in it?
No, it's just a joke. A little jive, but all in good fun. Not offensive at all.
What's the play called?
The Mousetrap. Why on earth is it called that, you ask? It's a metaphor. This play is about a murder committed in Vienna. Gonzago is the Duke's name, you'll see. It's terrible stuff, but nothing to trouble our minds, right? You and I are honest men, are we not? Let the guilty ones feel uncomfortable. This is Lucianus, the king's nephew in the play.
You're an expert commentator, aren't you?
Yes, I could even supply the dialogue between you and your lover if you did your little puppet show of love for me.
Oh, you are sharp.
Yes, pointy, but you could take the edge off me. Though it might make you moan a little.
You get better in your jokes and worse in your manners.
That's what you women get when you trick us into marriage. Let's get started. Moderate on stage, please. Stop fussing with the makeup and begin. We are all waiting for the revenge.
Evil thoughts! Ready hands! The right poison! And the time is right too! The dark night is on my side, for no one can see me! You deadly mixture of weeds and plants! Witch Hecate, goddess of witchcraft, has put a spell on. Use your magic to steal this healthy person's life away.
You see, he poisons the king in his own garden to get the kingdom for himself. The king's name is Gonzago. The original story was written in the finest Italian. You will see shortly how the murderer wins the love of Gonzago's wife.
The king is getting up!
What? Is he scared of a gun that only fired the blade?
My lord, how are you feeling?
Stop the play!
Get some light, get me out of here!
Light, get us some light!
Let the dearest Shakespeare shot go up and weep! While the unharmed dear happen to please! For some must watch while others must sleep! That's how the world goes! Oh, couldn't I get work as an actor in some acting company? Oh, Horatio, I bet you 1,000 bucks the ghost was right. Did you notice?
Yes, I did, my lord.
Oh, then, when the actors were talking about poison?
I watched them very closely.
Aha! Hey, let's have some music here! Play your flutes! For if the king doesn't like to play! Ha ha! Come on! Music!
My lord, can I have a word with you?
You can have a whole story, not just a word.
Sir, the king!
Yes? What about him?
He's in his chambers now, and he's extremely upset. And your mother, too, is upset and wants to speak with you.
He will come right away. Make sure you lay into him. Tell him that his pranks are too much, quite unbearable. And then your highness has taken a lot of heed for them. I'll be right here silent. Please be blunt with him.
Mother!
Don't worry, I'll do what you say. Now hide, I hear him coming.
Now, mother, what's this all about?
Hamlet, you have been insulted your father.
Mother, you have insulted my father.
Come on, you're answering me foolishly.
Go on, you're questioning me wickedly.
Hamlet, why? Why?
What's the problem then?
Have you forgotten who I am?
No, sit down. You won't budge until I hold a mirror up to you. Well, you will see what's deep inside
you. What are you going to do? You won't kill me, will you? Help!
Hey, help! Help! Help!
What's this? A rat? A dollar is a dead friend now!
I've been killed!
Oh my god! What have you done?
I don't know. Is it the king?
Oh, what a senseless, horrible act!
A horrible act? Almost as bad. My good mother, as killing a king and marrying his brother.
Killing a king?
That's what I said, my good woman. Miserable, nosy, interfering fool. Goodbye. I thought you were somebody more important. You've gotten what you deserve. Stop wringing your hands! Sit down and let me wring your hurt instead! Which I will do if it's still soft enough, if your evil life has not toughened it against all feeling.
What have I done that you dare to talk to me so rudely?
A deed that destroys modesty turns virtue into hypocrisy. Oh, you've done a deed that thrust the soul out of marriage. Heaven looks down and is sick at your actions.
What is this crime? This sounds so awful before I even know what it is.
Look at this picture here and that one there. The painted images of two brothers. Look at this one. With his curly hair and his forehead like a Greek god.
Oh.
Every god seemed to have set his stamp on this man. That was your husband. Now, look at this other one. Your present husband. Do you have eyes? How could you lift the lofty eyes of this man here and descend as low as this one? Ha! Do you have eyes? You cannot say you did it out of love, since at your age, romantic passions have grown weak and the heart obeys reason. But what reason could move you from this one to that one? What devil was it that blindfolded you? Eyes without feeling, feeling without sight, ears without hands or eyes, smell without anything else, the use of even one imperfect sense would not permit such a mistake as yours. Oh, for shame! Why are you blushing? If evil can overtake even an old mother's bones, then let it melt my own.
Oh, Henry, stop! You're making me look into my very soul. Where are the marks of sin are so thick and black, they will never be washed away.
Yes, oh. And you lie in the sweaty stench of your dirty sheets, wet with corruption, making love.
Oh, you must stop! Your words are like daggers. Please, no more, sweet Emily.
A murderer and a villain. A lowlife who's not worth the 20th of a tenth part of your first husband. The worst of kings, a thief of the throne, who took the precious crown and put it in his pocket?
Stop!
A scarecrow, an imposter. Oh, angels in heaven, protect me with your wings. What can I do for you, my gracious lord?
Oh no, Hamlet's gone completely crazy.
Have you come to scold your tardy son for straying from his mission, letting your important commands slip by? Tell me.
Don't forget. I've come to sharpen your dull appetite for revenge. But Lou, your mother is in shock. Oh, keep her struggling soul from being overwhelmed by horrid visions. The imagination works strongest in those with the weakest bodies. Talk to her, Hamlet.
Are you right, madam?
And how are you doing? Staring into the empty air and talking to nobody? Your eyes give away your white thoughts, and your hair is standing upright like soldiers during a call to arms. Oh, my dear son, of your seven, cool up your brilliant mind. What are you staring at?
At him! Look how pale he is and how he glares at me. Oh, don't look at me like that, unless you want me to cry instead of kill.
Who are you talking to?
You don't see anything?
Nothing at all. But I can see everything that's here.
And you don't hear anything?
No, nothing but us talking.
Look how I'm sneaking away. My father dressed just like he was when when he was alive. Look, he's going out the door right now.
This is only a figment of your imaginations. Madness is good at creating hallucinations.
Madness? Look, my heart beats just as evenly as yours does. There's nothing crazy in what I've just uttered. Put me to the test. I rephrase everything I've just said, which your lunatic couldn't do. Mother, for the love of God, don't flatter yourself into believing that it's my madness, that your crime that's the problem. You just be concealing the rot that's eating you from the inside. Oh, confess your sins to heaven, repent and avoid damnation.
Oh, Hamlet, you've broken my heart in two.
Then throw away the warsaw and live a purer life with the other. Oh, good night to you, but don't go to my uncle's bed tonight. Say no to sex tonight, and it will make it easier to say no next time. Heavy can't change even one's natural instincts and drive the devil out. Once again, good night to you. And when you want to repent, I ask you for your blessing too. God wanted to punish me with this murder, and this man with me. This is bad, but it'll get worse soon. Oh, and one other thing, mother.
What should I do?
Whatever you do, don't let the fat old king lure you into his bed again. So he can pinch your cheek, call you his bunny, and with filthy kisses and a massage of your neck with his damned fingers, make you reveal that my madness is fake, all calculated. Oh, what a great idea that would be!
You can rest easy, since words are made of breath, and breathing requires that you be alive. I feel too dead to breathe a word of what you've told me.
I have to go to England. Don't you know that?
Oh, I've forgotten all about that. It's been decided.
Yes, it's a done deal. It's all ready. And my two schoolmates, whom I trust about as much as rattlesnakes, are in charge. They're the ones who lead me to a treacherous death. Well, while they talk, let's see who gets blown up. Now that I've killed this guy, I'll be off in a hurry. I lock his guts into the next room. Mother, have a good night. This politician who was a babbling idiot is now quiet and serious. Come on, sir. Let's get to the end of our business. Good night, mother.
As You Like It 사막 1장 숙부의 시샘을 받고 궁정에서도 깨어난 로젤린드와 간악한 형 올리버에게 쫓긴 올란도는 아덴 숲에서 만나지만 올란도는 자신이 사랑하는 여인 로젤린드가 남장을 하여 그녀를 알아보지 못하고 그녀에게 로젤린드를 향한 사랑의 열병을 토로합니다. 그들의 사랑 함께 지켜보시죠.
The man I love.
I like to pretend you're Rosalind, because then it's almost like actually talking to her.
Well, on behalf of Rosalind, I'll tell you, I don't want you.
Then, on behalf of myself, I tell you, I die.
Oh, no!
I hope Rosalind doesn't fit as you do. Her problem will kill me.
No, her friend wouldn't kill a fly. But come on now. I'll play your Rosalind in a more friendly state of mind. Whatever you ask for, I'll get.
Then love me, Rosalind.
Okay, I will. On Fridays and Saturdays and the rest.
And will you help me?
Sure, and 20 others just like you.
What are you saying?
Well, aren't you a good man?
I hope so.
And can a person ever have too much of a good thing? Come on, sister! priest and marry us. Give me your hand, Orlando. What do you say, sister? You just have to say, do you, Orlando...
Oh, stop it!
Do you, Orlando, take Rosalind to be to be your lovely wedded wife?
I do.
Okay, but when?
Right now, as fast as she can see the vows.
Then you say, I take you, Rosalind, to be my lovely wedded wife.
I take you, Rosalind, to be my lovely wedded wife.
Maybe I should ask what right you have to take me. But I'll take you, Orlando, to be my husband. Look, I've sped ahead of the priest and answered the question before he even asked. A woman's thoughts are always running ahead of her actions.
So the thoughts, they have wings.
Now tell me, how long you intend to keep her?
Forever and a day.
You might as well just say for a day and forget the ever part. No, Orlando, men are like April when they're wooing a girl, young and passionate. But like December once they're married, and their passions have cooled. Women are sweet and temperate as springtime when they are single, but the climate changes once they are married. I'll be more jealous of you than a wonder rooster over his hen, more noisy than a parrot chattering about the rain, more fond of new things than a monkey, more crazy about having my way than an ape. I'll cry and cry about nothing at all, and always when you're in a good mood. And when you want to go to sleep, I'll be up laughing like a hyena.
But will my Rosalind do this too?
Indeed, she'll act just like me.
But she's wise.
Right, she needs to be smart enough to behave badly. The wiser the woman, the wilder. If you close the doors on a woman's suite, it will fly out the window. If you shut the windows, it will pour out the keyhole. If you stop out the keyhole, it will escape from the chimney along with the smoke.
A man with a wife like my desk. Hey, Wonderwind, where are you off to?
Nah, better save the questions for when you find her in your neighbor's bed.
And what wind could excuse that?
She'll say she was at the neighbor's looking for you. You'll never find her without an answer, unless you find her without a tongue. A woman who doesn't know how to make her indiscretions look like her husband's fault is hardly a woman. She's hardly fit to be a mother. Her child will turn out to be a fool.
Rosalind, I have to leave before 2 hours.
Oh no, oh darling! I can live without you for 2 hours!
I must join the Duke for lunch. I will be back here with you by 2 o'clock.
Oh, go, leave me! I knew it would turn out this way. My friends told me as much, and I knew it too. But I was won over by your flattering words. I'm just another girl whom you've cast aside. So take me this! You'll be back at 2 o'clock?
Yes, Rosalind.
Honestly, truly, in God's name, and by all those little girly oaths that don't actually have any power, if you break even a little bit of your promise, or if you come even a minute after 2 o'clock, I'll think you the most apathetic promise breaker, the most lying lover, and the most unworthy partner for Rosalind that could be found anywhere. So beware of my contempt and keep your promise.
I'll keep my promise, just as if you really were Rosalind, so goodbye.
Well, time is the old judge that tries your kind of criminal. Time will tell what kind of a man you are. Goodbye.
Oh, Rosalind! You have absolutely abused our sex in this love talk of yours. We should revolve your man's clothing and show the world the woman who has represented her own kind so terribly.
Oh, cousin, my sweet little cousin. I wish you knew how deep in love I am. The bottom of a love is so deep, it can't be reached. It's as deep as the Bay of Portugal. Cupid, the blind bastard son of Venus, conceived from a sudden anger, born from insanity. That blind naughty boy who makes everyone else go blind just because he can't see himself. Let Cupid judge how deep my love runs. I'm telling you, Celia, I can't stand being apart from Orlando. I'm going to find some shade and sigh until he returns.
Oh, Midsummer, nice dream. 2막 1장, 3막 1장, 4막 1장. 개구쟁이 요정 로빈에 의해 당나귀 머리로 변한 바텀. 오베론의 마법에 걸린 티타니아는 당나귀로 변한 바텀에게 첫눈에 반하게 됩니다. 마지막 연극 시작합니다.
I have to go. Who are these country bumpkins? around so close? To where the fairy queen is sleeping. What? Are they going to put on a play? I'll watch it. I'll even act in it if I feel like it.
Speak, Pyramus. This we come for.
This be flowers with sweet odious smells.
Odors. Odors.
Odors and smells like a breath, my dearest Spidier. What's that? A voice. Wait here a while. I'm right back.
That's the strangest Pyramus I've ever seen.
Am I supposed to now?
Yes, you are. You're supposed to show that you understand that Pyramus just went to check on the noise here, and is coming right back.
Most radiant Pyramus, you are as white as a lily, and the color of a red rose on a splendid rose bush. You are as reliable as a horse that never gets tired. I'll meet you, Pyramus, at Ninus' grave.
That's Ninus' grave, man. And don't say all of it yet. You're supposed to say some of it as a reply to Pyramus.
Oh, as reliable as a horse that never gets tired. I'm not in a fairy. I rule with the summer, and I love you. So come with me. as humans do. Come here, people of sun, co-whip, mustard seed. Come over here and sit down on this furry bed. While I caress those love of a tree, I will put roses on your silky smooth head and kiss your big, beautiful ears. My gentle darling.
Where is Pibulosom?
Here.
Scratch my head, Pibulosom. Where's Monsieur Cobweb?
Here, sir.
Monsieur Cobweb, sir, get out your weapons and kill me a striped bumblebee on a thistle. And bring me its honey. Don't tie yourself up, Monsieur. Oh, and Monsieur, be careful not to break the honey sack.
By the way, sir.
I'd hate to see you drown in honey, sir.
Okay, sir.
Where's Monsieur Mustard Seed?
Here.
Give me your hand, Mr. Mustard Seed. Please stop bowing. Good, sir.
What do you like me to do?
Nothing good, sir, except to scratch my head. I should go to the barber's, Monsieur, because I'm getting really hairy around the face. And I'm such a sensitive ass that if my hair even tickles me a little, I need to scratch.
Would you like to hear some music, my sweet love?
I have a pretty good ear for music. Let's hear someone play the triangle and the sticks.
Or tell me, my sweet love, what do you like to eat?
Actually, I'd like a few pounds of grass. I'd like to munch on some good dry oats, or maybe I've got a craving for some hay. There's nothing like a good bundle of hay. Really sweet hay.
I have an adventurous fairy who will scout us grass secret fish and get you some fresh nuts.
I'd rather have a handful of top dry peas. But please, don't let any of your people wake me up. I really want to sleep now.
Go to sleep and I'll wrap my arms around you. Fairies, go away, run away all directions. I'm putting my arms around you, just like the woodbine can dream gently twist itself around the sweet honeysuckle. And like the female bee curls itself around the branches of the elm tree. Oh, how I love you. I'm so crazy about you.
Welcome, good loving. Do you see this sweet sight? Now I'm starting to pity Titania for being so infatuated. With this hyper idiot, she put fresh, fragrant flowers around his hairy forehead, and the drops of dew that lay in the center of the flowers made the flowers look like they were crying with shame to be decorating the head of that ugly jackass. When I had taunted her as much as I wanted to, and she begged me very nicely to leave her alone, I asked her to give up the little prince. She agreed right away. And good loving, remove this transformed donkey set from the shoulders of the Athenian man, so he won't be such a mess when he wakes up. But first, I will release a fairy queen from the spell. Like he used to be, as he like he used to see, this bird belongs to Diana, goddess of virginity, and it has the power to undo the effects of Cupid's flower. Now, Titania, welcome, my sweet queen.
Well, I had such a strange dream. I dreamed I was in love with an S.
There's your boyfriend, sleeping right there.
How did this happen? Oh, I hate looking in his face now.
Be quiet for a while. Robin, take off his donkey head. Titania, get the fairies to play some music.
Music, play the kind of music that makes people dream and wonder.
When you wake up, see things with your own foolish eyes again, you idiot.
Play the music. Take my hands, my queen, and we'll lure these people to sleep with our gentle dancing. Now that you and I are friends again, we can dance for Duke Theseus of Athens tomorrow at midnight, and bless his marriage and his marriage bed, and all those noisy other lovers can get married alongside him, and they will all be in high spirits.
Thank you.
1학번 이재현입니다.
감사합니다.
제가 이번 연극을 통해서 사실 이런 거 하지도 못하고 그리고 이런 치마 같은 거 입는 것도 되게 싫어하고 이렇게 정말 발랄한 것을 막 이렇게 겉으로 표현을 못한다고 생각을 했는데 이번에 이거 통해서 되게 좋았고요.
울지마
이제 따라자!
이쪽으로 안 되는 거야? 어떻게
그래서 저는 서든리든 도얼스든 이번 공연이 너무너무 좋았습니다.
저는 클라디우스랑 올란도 그리고 머스타드 시드를 맡게 된 정도윤입니다. 사실 저는 중간에 참여하게 됐는데 그래서 되게 처음에는 이렇게 힘든지 몰라가지고 기대하다가 이제 점점 하면서 솔직히 시간을 뺏긴다 그리고 힘들다 이런 생각을 했는데 오늘 이렇게 공연을 하고 나서 끝나니까 홀가분하고 되게 보람차네요. 감사합니다.
안녕하세요. 와! 와! 고스트랑 그 요정왕 오베론을 맡은 이건섭입니다. 네. 제가 원래 목소리도 작고 그 뻣뻣해서 되게 힘들었는데 열심히 연습해서 그래도 잘 했던 것 같습니다. 감사합니다.
네, 햄릿이었고요. 네, 요정 아까 빨간 옷 했었고, 네, 와주셔서 감사드리고, 안드레아, thank you for coming. And, 네, 저희 지적, 네, 막 우리 누나들도 막 지적해주시라 고생해주시고, 일사왕권 누님들도 정말 밤늦게까지 저희 봐주시면서 정말 감사하고, 일단 햄릿이라는 역할을 제게 만들어준 황환호 학생에게 정말 감사하게 생각합니다. 네. 중학생 덕분에 제가 도어스에 들어오게 됐어요. 네, 그리고 네, 지켜봐주셔서 감사했고 좀 아쉽네요 끝나니까. 그래도 잘 했나요 나름?
네.
아, 네.
네.
감사합니다.
네. 안녕하세요. 14번 도어스 부학회장 박지연입니다. 네, 이번에 24기 도어스 부학회장 맡게 됐는데요. 진짜 두 달 동안
울지마
마이크만 잡으면 다 울지 마.
저희 두 달 동안 진짜 열심히 했거든요.
건기야 가서 달려줘.
미쳐. 건기 누른다.
제가 1학번 애들한테 이거 하면서 되게 안 좋게 말을 많이 하게 돼서 지적도 많이 하게 돼서 마음이 안 좋았는데 그거는 진짜 진심으로 한 게 아니라 다 잘 되라고 한 거니까 다 마음에 담아두지 않았으면 좋겠고 아예방 교수님이랑 회장 지현이랑 그리고 13학번 언니들, 23기 언니들 도와주셔서 정말 정말 감사드리고요. 저희 내년 도얼스 계속해서 도얼스 계속 하니까 내년도 도얼스 많이 관심 가져주시고 보러 많이 와주세요. 저희 두 달 동안 많이 연습 열심히 했는데 너무 일찍 끝나서 아쉽지만 보러 와주셔서 정말 감사합니다.
네. 안녕하세요. 도얼스 25기 회장 김지연입니다. 사실 이거 도얼스 하면서 초반에는 친구들도 많이 들어왔는데 많이 나가기도 하고 이렇게 남은 친구들도 몇 안 되는 것 같지만 막상 이렇게 도얼스 준비하면서 사람들을 이렇게 한 군데로 모으는 게 진짜 힘들다는 걸 너무 많이 느꼈어요. 그런데도 마지막에 돼서는 이렇게 다들 너무 잘해줘서 진짜 저 무대 뒤, 저기 뒤에서 진짜 너무 심장이 떨리면서 봤는데 너무 잘하더라고요. 다 무대 체질인가 봐요. 그래서 너무 고맙고 사실 제가 이거 하면서도 사람을 모으는 거에 힘들다는 것도 느꼈지만 제 스스로가 이렇게 부족한 사람이었나를 많이 느꼈거든요. 그래서 아, 뭐 그래서 같이 고생해준 지연이 너무 고맙고 열심히 잘 따라와준 1호 학번 친구들도 너무 고맙고 이반 교수님한테도 감사하고 저희 24학기 회장, 부회장 언니한테도 너무 감사합니다. 더 다 감사해요. 감사합니다.
안녕하세요.
와.
안녕하세요. 저는 겉투르랑 퀸스 역을 맡은 1호 학번 정예지라고 합니다. 네. 저는 제 역할이 이렇게 막 오열을 해야 하는 역할인지 몰랐는데 어떻게 오열을 하게 됐네요. 준비하는 동안 힘든 점도 있었어요. 있었지만 근데 이제 여기 선배들이랑 또 전 학년 선배님들 오셔가지고 저희 많이 정말 많이 도와주셨거든요. 그래서 그 선배님들 보면서 진짜 열심히 해야겠구나 라고 많이 느껴서 더 그런 힘든 생각보다는 좀 열심히 해야겠다라는 생각을 많이 했어요. 그리고 이제 내년에 지수랑 같이 두얼스를 이끌어 나가게 될 회장이 되었습니다. 네. 저희 두얼스 더 열심히 할 테니까 앞으로도 많은 관심 부탁드립니다. 감사합니다.
안녕하세요. 저는 호레시오랑 저는 허리시오랑 로잘린 언니랑 그 피블러썸 역을 맡았는데 뭔가 연기를 잘하는 스타일이 아니었는데 뻣뻣한 저를 잘 지도해주신 언니들하고 아이반 교수님 감사드리고 내년에도 두얼스 열심히 하겠습니다. 감사합니다.
안녕하세요. 저는 햄릿에서 오펠리아 역할이랑 그리고 마지막에 플루트